Well, hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. And in today's video, I will talk about a very special place, Georgia Institute of Technology, or Georgia Tech, commonly known as. Georgia Tech is one of the leading universities when it comes to engineering and technical courses. Although, don't get me wrong, they have a number of other courses you can explore and get involved in. Let's try and understand it better for more insight into its working. Hi, I'm Shirish Gupta, and I empower people to hack their success, rise above the challenges, and confidently create an extraordinary life they deserve. Georgia Tech is located in Atlanta, a city in Georgia, United States. Atlanta is the state capital of US state, Georgia. The temperature is pleasant, and those of you looking for decent weather may be satisfied with the location. It's not too warm and not too cold either. Atlanta ranks third in the US in terms of largest concentration of Fortune 500 companies, which definitely helps with the placement. Georgia Tech campus located just off the interstate in Georgia's capital city, and Tech's 450-acre campus embraces 40 undergraduate residence halls, an aquatic center, a sports performance complex, and an amphitheater. The campus architecture is like traveling through time. Yes, all kinds of building architecture is present here, from Georgian history to Gothic to modern high-tech facilities. All of these styles coexist comfortably on a tree-filled, landscaped campus that serves as a green oasis in the midst of a dense urban environment. The most popular majors at Georgia Tech include industrial engineering, biomedical engineering, aerospace engineering, civil engineering, mechanical, computer science, mathematics, and architecture. Like always, it's my duty to emphasize on the fact that ranking should never be the sole selection criteria for any college on your list. But still, since people, they want to know about Georgia Tech, it is still comfortably in the top 10% of colleges in the US as well as in the world, all across major ranking services provided like US News, QS News, especially when you look for technology-driven courses. All right, let's move on to the next section, talking about the right fit. Now, universities have personality, as do all the people in the world. Mostly, it can be decoded by just going through the university website thoroughly and interpreting the hidden messages or mottos the colleges display. I understand it, that can be a bit tricky interpreting that relevant information, so let me try to help you out here. Let's start with what you mean by the right fit. A good college fit is when a college meets your needs and wants academically, socially, and financially. And today, we will cover all these three fits for Georgia Tech and whether this particular university will be a good fit for you or not. So let's begin with the first one, the academic fit. Georgia Tech is tech-driven college, so interest in technology is crucial. The academic environment here is extremely rigorous. Most students feel the heat and pressure of this, and it can be stressful and tiresome for those who can't cope up with such a heavy workload. And it's common for students to complete their degrees in 5 years instead of four due to the tech-demanding programs. But one additional factor contributing to the delayed graduation is their co-op program tour. The class size is average to about 50 students per class, others ranging from as less as 10 students to as much as 300 students in a class. Faculty members have real-world experience. Some are Nobel Prize winners and former NASA astronauts. Isn't that exciting? But direct access to them is tough, and you will need to fight through a wall of graduate students to get to talk to the professors, especially if you are an undergrad student. Each of Georgia Tech's undergraduate students, regardless of major, must complete credit hours in social sciences, science, English and humanities, mathematics, US or Georgian history, US and global perspectives, and wellness. Although the student-faculty ratio at Georgia Tech is an impressive 18:1, as mentioned earlier, 26% of the classes are more than 50 students, so it's mostly big class size. The tech department offers more than 90 exchange programs and 30 faculty-led study abroad programs. 52% of students have some sort of international study or internship experience by the time they graduate, and that's pretty amazing. In addition to this, Georgia Tech's Business College is very popular as well, and its School for Architecture has done amazing work in historic preservation and energy conservation fields. One of the architecture program's alumni is Michael Arad, a designer who designed the September 11 Memorial in Lower Manhattan. Yes. The pre-law certificate is the boon to aspiring patent attorneys, as this is a minor in law, science, and technology. Georgia Tech has plenty of liberal arts courses, but most students, they don't really enroll for these courses like history, philosophy, and English because their focus is more on tech. So keeping all this in mind, I will rate Georgia Tech with 5 stars on academic difficulty level, where 5 is the highest level. Well, after academic fit, let's move to the social fit. Well, I'm going to be honest with you here. Social life at Georgia Tech is dismal. If you're looking for lazy weekends and partying on the weekends, go elsewhere. You have to be both tough and dedicated to succeed at Georgia Tech. According to students here, there are a lot of left brain types here, high on introspection and thinking, low on social skills. Everybody is so engrossed with their work. So Georgia Tech has above 20,000 students with around 13,000 as undergrad and remaining PG and PhD students. As for the last year's number, 9% of students are international. Rest around 58% of undergrads hail from Georgia, and there are large contingents from California, Florida, and Texas. Well, let's talk about housing here. 43% of undergraduates live in the dorms, where freshmen are guaranteed housing. According to students, there are mixed housing options. Some dorms are new, apartment style, and nice. Others are foul, dungeous. Off-campus housing is generally comfortable, but some of the parts of the surrounding neighborhood are risky, where regular car robberies happen. Campus police are said to be quick to respond to the incidents, but there are some chances of these kind of things. The campus dining halls offer little variety and less quality, so it's better to get meal plans from outside where you can choose what you want to eat. Georgia Tech has Division I varsity sports. About 40% of students participate in university's 43 clubs and 20 intramural sports. Men's swimming, women's basketball, and men's and women's track and golf have been successful in recent years. Georgia Tech offers a balance between academics and social activities. I would give it 2 stars out of 5 on the quality of life at Georgia Tech. Now let's look at the financial fit. Georgia Tech is an average school like the fee-wise. The tuition cost is about $40,000 to $50,000, including living, with room and board is about $13,000. So it surely lies in the middle of not so expensive and not too cheap as a school. Scholarships and financial aids are available for students, although just 11% of freshmen qualify for the Pell Grant. There is extreme competition on who gets to that. Merit scholarships average about $5,600 and are about 182 athletic scholarships. So overall, I will give 3 stars on the financial fit for Georgia Tech. After exploring the fit, let's move to the most curious section on how to get admission to Georgia Tech. Before I decode that for you, let's just look at some of the facts here. Georgia Tech is yet another one of highly selective schools, and it surely lies in either REACH school or dream school for almost everyone, as it has acceptance rate of about 20%. With this level of competitiveness, Georgia Tech is sure to expect new enrollments from students top of their academic game, more like top 10 to 15% of the application pool. Interest in technology is crucial, and having a good research background will come in handy when trying to impress application officers here. So if you feel you fit the academic profile of Georgia Tech student, this might be the perfect school for you. Georgia Tech has a strict discipline review policy for each of their new enrollments. So any disciplinary action from school or college can result in negative points on your profile. They consider student discipline situations on an individual basis within the framework of the values of the universities. So make sure not to get into any trouble with your teachers. You need stellar recommendations, remember that. Consistent with its mission to improve the human condition in Georgia, the United States, and around the globe, Georgia Tech counts the diversity of its students among its greatest strengths and an integral component of its educational process and academic excellence. Now let's move on to my admission advice to get an admission to Georgia Tech. Well, these ideas are not available anywhere and comes from my decade-long experience working with students for career and college admission. For admission to Georgia Tech, technology-driven profiles will always be looked at with additional interest. So make sure your math, physics, computer science projects are aligned with new technology. Internships with tech startups are another way for improving your profile for Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech's mission is to develop leaders who advance technology and improve the human condition. Its mission and strategic plan are focused on making a positive impact in the lives of people everywhere. So make sure to look for the impact in your word. Yes, that's the word, impact. Do more than what your school is providing you. Go outside the box. Take online courses from Coursera, edX, or any other university platform. Join hackathons. Join school, non-school clubs. Get involved in research. Do more than what is given to you directly. Your efforts won't go waste at all. So if you choose Georgia Tech to be one of your schools, well, there are 2 deadlines for undergraduate applications and program-specific 1 or multiple for PGs. My advice is if Georgia Tech is something you are seriously considering, apply early. In the end, to conclude, if you're someone who doesn't care about social life, partying, at all, and has a long-term focus and deep career drive, Georgia Tech is your holy grail. It's the tough road that will lead you to your glorious success. But remember, you have to be truly ambitious, self-driven, and must love a good and long challenge. P.S. You will get away with poor social skills here. Thank you for watching this video. And if you think this is really helpful, do like this video and do subscribe to the channel and press that bell icon so you get notified of the new videos whenever they are out. Also, you can check out the other university-related videos right here on my channel. And we'll bring back new videos for you next week. Till then, see you. Bye-bye.